Today we are going to study science, second section, first topic, heredity and evolution. Heredity and evolution. Heredity and evolution are both terms are very important in this topic. Let us study first heredity. So what is mean by heredity? Before studying this, we will see that all students look like, means some students look like their parents. They are not exactly like their parents. Why? Because there are some variations comes in this because of some different characters. So means grandparents transfer their characters to their parents, then again to their offsprings. The characters pass from their grandparents towards the parents, again from parents to their offspring, and this process is known as heredity. So the exactly meaning of heredity is transfer of genetic characters from parents to their offspring, again to their offspring, again to their offspring. This whole process is also known as inheritance. Heredity is a continuous process, and due to this, there is a changes occurs due to some variations. Now, let us study how many characters, which are the types of characters comes under the offspring. There are two types of characters. First one, inherited characters. So, what do you mean by inherited characters? All of you see, some parents' eye color is supposed eyeball color is black. Their offspring eyeball color is also black. Then this is the inherited character. Some parents' height is more, their offspring height is also more, then it is also inherited character. Sometimes tallness, color of the eyeball, hair color, length of the hair, these characters comes from their parents, these are the inherited characters. But the next type is the acquired character. Acquired character. So what do you mean by acquired character? Some characters are acquired by the human beings by doing some exercise, by getting some muscles. These are the acquired character. These are not coming from the parents. So there are two types of characters: inherited characters and acquired characters. Now, this complete process occurs due to change in a DNA. So, what is mean by DNA? DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid present in a chromosome. This DNA copying, DNA copying occurs during this inheritance, and during copying some errors are occurs. Means while DNA copying from grandparents to parents, from parents to offspring, some errors are occurs during generations. Like this, suppose this is the first generation G1, next one G2, third one G3, then G4, like this continuous generations occurs, and during this first to second, second to third, third to fourth, DNA copying occurs and some variations, some errors are denoted while copying the DNA. And due to this, there is a variations occurs. So, this term is known as variations. So, we are not looking exactly. Suppose in variation, V1 is the first generation. then V2, V3. These variation comes from first to second, second to third, and this is known also as evolution. So what is mean by evolution? Our second major point is evolution. In evolution, step by step progress is called as a evolution. Evolution is not a sudden process. It gets time. And how this evolution occurs in a human being? Suppose all we heard about that, at olden days, we are in like a monkey. And from the monkey, we develop like a human beings. So, monkeys or apes, these are our old ones, ancestors, called as a ancestors. And we develop from the our ancestor. And this also, this process is known as a evolution. So, exactly, we will see that what is mean by evolution. Step by step progress, and which is a permanent process. Afterwards, it get a permanent change in our life cycle, and this is known like spring. This is known as a evolution. So, step by step progress. Step by step progress. And afterwards, it get permanent. It gets permanent. Known as evolution. And due to this evolution, how this evolution occurs? Due to the DNA. DNA variation. It is not exactly similar to our old ones. We are different from our old ones. Now, Mendel, Gregor Mendel, who was called as a father of genetics, he done some experiments for this DNA copy. And he studied that evolution means how the evolution occurs from old ones to the modern one. For this, he selected one plant, Pisum sativum. And this Pisum sativum, why did he choose the Pisum sativum? Because he occurs seven contrasting characters in Pisum sativum. Which one those? First one, height of this plant. Second one, color of the seed. Shape of the seed. Shape of seed means all of you know. Green peas. Yellow peas. Shape, wrinkle, round. Color, yellow, green. Height, tall, dwarf. Then color of flower, red. And white. Flower position, sometimes axil, sometimes it is a terminal. Like these characters occurs in a Pisum sativum, and one major important characteristic of the Pisum sativum is the lifespan of this plant is a very very short, and so in less time we can study more generations of this plant. And for that purpose, Mendel selected this plant. Selected Pisum sativum. We call as a pea plant. Transcription and translation. In short, transcription and translation. Translation. These both processes occurs due to change in a DNA. All of you know DNA present in a chromosome, DNA present in a nucleus, and nucleus present in a cell. Now see, this one is a cell. Inside cell, there is a nucleus. And here is a outside the nucleus, there is a presence of two types of RNA. There are majorly three types of RNA. First one, mRNA, rRNA and tRNA. From these three, mRNA present inside the nucleus. mRNA present inside the nucleus, and these both rRNA and tRNA are present outside the nucleus. In mRNA, mRNA is present in a nucleus. DNA is present in nucleus. This DNA transfers into the mRNA. This total process occurs inside the nucleus. So, formation of mRNA from DNA, this process is known as transcription. Formation of mRNA from DNA is known as transcription, and this mRNA again comes out of the nucleus, and mRNA comes out of the nucleus and forms protein. So, formation of protein from mRNA is known as translation. In short, if we want to describe again, DNA forms mRNA, mRNA forms protein, DNA forms mRNA called as a transcription. This protein form from RNA called as a translation. And both these comes to form central dogma. Central dogma means from this one line we can describe as transcription and translation comes to form a central dogma. Now, during next period, we will study about transcription in detail. Over.